last service of the service. I want to go to a meeting like that. And what you guys are about to do is really, for your child, it's about the most important thing in the world that they don't understand. They're just like, look, and they don't get it. But if you will follow through on this public dedication, you're publicly, you could have just dedicated your child at home. The fact that you're, and you probably have, but the fact that you're doing it publicly, you're standing before your church family, and you're saying, I made the decision, I'm going to raise my child to know and love the Lord. If you will follow through on this decision, your child will be great. Okay? There's just nothing greater in the world than a mom or dad above who really loves the Lord. Do you remember last week Jesus said, do not hinder the little ones from coming to me? And we talked about how do you do that? How do you keep your kids away from God? Through hypocritical living? You don't want to be that way. Through irresponsible parenting? By that I mean not taking the responsibility, the time to place the teaching of your children, spiritual things, making that your priority. Through parental unbelief, if your faith is not strong in the Lord, if you don't know the Lord, your children are at a terrible disadvantage spiritually. You must lead the way back. And then through not understanding how important they are, misunderstanding of the importance of children. Jesus said they're so important. He said we adults have to become like them in order to enter the kingdom. They don't become like us. We've got to become like them. We've got to have a childlike faith. We must humble ourselves to enter the kingdom of God. I don't want us to hinder the kids. I want us to help the kids come to the Lord. This morning, what I'm asking you to do, I think what you've already determined to do, I don't have to ask you. You've made up your mind already. We're drawing a line in the sand. And we are saying that we are going to know God and love God, and God's going to be first in our lives. And we are going to use all the influence we have to teach our children to know God and love God also. Did y'all hear me? What you're really saying this morning is I'm dedicating myself to bring my child up where my child will know who God is and who will love the Lord. What you're saying is my child is going to be more important to me than my career, my job. It's more important. By the way, because your child is so important to you, it's so important for mom and dad to fall in love with each other and stay in love with each other. That's just going to help your child. Y'all understand that? Now, there are going to be many issues, many problems. By the time you're my age, you're going to be thanking God for growing up, okay? You're going to be ready. But there's the greatest gift God's ever given you outside, John, outside of your salvation. So there's no greater gift. Y'all know that, don't you? I'm going to ask you to turn around and face the crowd. And I'm going to ask as we pray that each one of you pick out a baby kind of in front of you there. And as I pray out loud, I want you to, everybody, we ought to have maybe 10 or 15 eyes focused on every one of these babies. And I want you to pray quietly in your heart for these little ones as I pray out loud. Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, as best we understand how we dedicate these children to you, they came from you, Lord. You're the giver of life. Lord, we know that children are a heritage given to us from God. Lord, Paul taught us that we all came from you and we're all going back to you. Lord, in the meantime, these moms and dads have been entrusted with these little ones by you. Lord, give them wisdom. Lord, if a mom and dad needs anything, they need wisdom. And Lord, give them patience. And Lord, just fill their hearts with love. Love for these children. But Lord, as much as they love their children, I pray that they will come to love you even more. Lord, if they love you totally, completely, they will love these children. Lord, please don't let the evil one have his way with any of these kids. Lord, statistically, it could be some bad news for some of these kids, statistically. But Lord, you're greater than statistics. And I ask that you just put your protective arms around each one of them. Lord, you're the one that said, let the little ones come to me and forbid them not. Lord, today, what we're really trying to do is bring our children to you. We're placing them on your lap, in your arms. And Lord, save them. Fill them with your spirit. Use them. May every one of them be just strong and mighty in the Lord. Every one of them, Lord, these parents, Lord, may they dedicate themselves to be fully devoted to you 100%. And Lord, thank you. Thank you for letting us as a church share in this great blessing this morning. Lord, these are beautiful children. They're so beautiful. And Lord, if they're beautiful to us, how much more beautiful must they be to you? Lord, I know they're precious to you. Lord, please protect them and save them. And we pray these things in your name. Moms and dads, congratulations to these.